Hello, comic book fans. Today I want to show you a lot of books from Nobrow, a British publisher of high quality comics for the most part. They are also very into illustration, which shows in their Nobrow magazines. I've shown them in another video, so just a quick mentioning of these. Half of the stuff here are comics, and when you flip the page, when you flip the book, you have a book with illustrations. So, these books are really neat, and yeah, again, watch my older video if you want to see a bit more of them. One exception, Nobrow 10, about Studio Dreams. I've shown you this not in that old video because it's a new book, and in it are for this time almost no comics, but illustrations from the artists who imagine their dream studio of the sorts. On high quality paper, you almost want to eat it, as good as this paper. High production values are very typical for this publisher. Could have been soon binding, of course, but yeah, especially with these double page illustrations. But you can't get it all, and I think this would be really just too expensive if they would have done it in soon binding. Otherwise, this is really a perfect book. The paper stock is fantastic, always. That's always true with the Nobrow productions. Even with their smaller efforts, like these 17 times 23 books, in which they are testing new talent, give them a chance to publish shorter stories. My favorite here is the Mean Girls Club, about these 50s, 60s style girls. That you may find in some weird fetish magazines or something like that. But it's Ryan Heschka has really here is fun with this gang of characters. But if you're looking for really fleshed out character with a lot of depth, this book will certainly not be something for you. This is just goofy B-movie pulpy trash and very quick read. But if you want more of the same, like me, then you may want to buy this recently published hardcover, Pink Dawn, with the same characters, and the story is more of the same. And even though the story from the floppy here, yeah, this is not a floppy, this is cardboard stock and thick paper, but you know what I mean, single issue. The story isn't included here, so you really get new stories for your buck, but in the exact same vein, and that was fine for me. Not the most original stories of all time, but yeah, good, dirty fun. I have some other of the series here, some books of this 17 times 23 series. Joe Sparrow the Hunter, nice story, even though fantasy-ish, even though it was a bit distracting that he used this computer graphics. It's almost retro, primitive, retro aesthetics here. I don't know why he used that. Wasn't so much my cup of tea. Nice story, nevertheless. Golem chick about one kid and his golem friend. Again, nice story, not too exciting. Won't change your world, but it it doesn't cost too much, so it's okay. Overall, Nobrow isn't the publisher that you can go to when you want to have totally exciting stories. It's generally speaking more about the art, and doing some whacked out story here and there, of course, or interesting story. So you get fantastic art, really stylish illustrations and tasteful illustrations, I would say. It's not that crazed out over the top modernism that I do like a lot with other publishers like Koyama Press, for an instance, but this more subdued retro modernist feel, maybe, to show you this. Maybe I can show you the spectators. This is actually interesting story-wise, because though there isn't really a story that unfolds, but more an essay on how we create the world through watching and being watched. And this is the general premise, like I understood it. Even though there are some weird sci-fi alien-ish elements to it. Yeah, but as you can see, the illustrations are top-notch. They are not, they are modern in this, yeah, way of classic modern, if this isn't a contradiction in itself. I would say their house style is for the most part like it's a bit stuck in the 70s or 80s. No, not in the 80s, 70s, 60s, 70s. Let's take, for instance, their educational books here. High Times. That's not a comic either. It's a Leporello with the story of aviation. Can put this out. Done by a Berlin-based couple. Really fitting there. If I've read it, remember it correctly, they are based in a kindergarten. So this has really a feel of a kinder book, these educational children books, starting with Icarus. And you can, of course, flip this around. And then you have the second part of the history of aviation. So, and the same thing they have done with the history of locomotion. Printed on thick paper stock or cardboard even. Nice little books. Somewhat educational, and sometimes Nobrow develops this thing for educational stuff. I've shown you this neurocomic by Matteo Farinella and Hannah Roche before in a video. I love this cover. I can't show you this often enough. And inside you have a more cartoony explanation how our nerve systems, our nerves and brain works. For real, that's really you will be more intelligent after that. That's fine. Of all the stories in that 17 times 23 format, The Cyber Realm by Ren MacDonald is maybe the juiciest, gives you the most story, even if maybe if it's just because of the higher panel count in this nice little book here. I was pleasantly surprised by that one. So, Farming, really, I hope they will come out with a third and last book of that trilogy. This is really whacked out stuff, and the cartooning isn't so no-brow, typical no-brow as well, for the most part. Could have been this stuff here, this goofy, weird art, would fit into the offerings of Koyama Press as well. Recently I've read Robert Moses, The Master Builder of New York, which is a translation from the French, written by one of my favorite European writers, Pierre Christine, and drawn by one Olivier Ballet, who I've guess never seen or read anything about. But this book here is a very interesting story about, yes, that guy here, Robert Moses, who started as a new hope for New York city planning, mapping out the city, doing the big projects, saying the telling the architects what they have to build. He really built New York over many decades. He was way too willing to give space for streets, the cars, and that was in the end his downfall, because he planned, let me show you, this monster of a street in Manhattan, which fortunately wasn't built. So yeah, you can see how Mr. Moses formed New York for the better, and in his later years clearly for the worst. And this is a compelling read. Yeah, very interesting. And yeah, you can't do usually go wrong with Pierre Christine, who is, by the way, the author of Valerian et Laureline, by the way. How to Survive in the North by Luke Healy. It's one of these books that are obsessed with the obsessions of scientists with the polar regions, done in this reduced style. And I almost can fill half of a shelf with these books depicting stories about the discovery and exploration of the polar regions. Okay, two books to go, Map of Days and A Graphic Cosmogony, are both involved with creation myths, how this world came into being, our world came into being. And Graphic Cosmogony has, yeah, the title here gives it away, 24 artists take on 7 pages to tell their tales of the creation of everything. And yeah, 24/7, you get the trick here. It refers to the Christian mythology, even though they go way behind and beside that, of course, and every artist does his very own thing. And when you look at these pages here, at least you get what I'm saying when I say that no-brow is a bit stuck in the world of 50s up to 70s illustration. fantastic paper, printing qualities. You will rip these pages out of the book and want to pin them on your wall, but of course you won't do that. And this is soon binding and just fantastic, colorful, really neat. Maybe I do a video just about this book here. Comic Crack recommended it way back then, and it's maybe my first book from Nobrow. So yeah. And here's Map of Days. Many things that I've said about A Graphic Cosmogony can be said about this book as well, even though it's done by just one artist. But it's obsessing about a weird creation tale that is about an old clock here. It's hard not to admire this kind of stuff here, I think. Just when you look at these first pages here. Sorry for the shakiness of this video. I'm fumbling a lot around lately. Sometimes the light isn't right. Sometimes the setup here is a bit problematic. I've never seen really what I've shown you. I'm really curious if this video that I've recorded right now is good enough to show you guys and girls. Anyhow, thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.